I am Campaign, and we live here, Campaign TV. We're in the building with none other than the Street Sweepers, cool DJ Foot.
You already know. What's up, baby? What's happening? 106.5 The Beat and all that. You already know.
Yeah. You see him. So, man, we in the building. Y'all see it, man. We finally made a little something in the streets. We in the 106.5 The Beat. So, you know, we're going to go ahead and get started, man.
Here we go.
Well, check this out, man. Yeah. So, I know you're from the Burg. Did you start? Is that where you started first DJing, or?
Actually, you might be a little too young to remember, but it was a club down there called 24 South Union.
Okay.
Back in the day, you know, I used to be the house DJ down there, and you know, everything panned out. It just came together because they had a new station come along, and then they wanted to cater to Petersburg, and they were like, "Well, let's get you on the radio." So I mean, once I got in that door, it just opened other doors for me.
Oh, okay. And you took off after that.
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. So before that, let me ask you this: who is there a specific DJ that, or somebody that inspired you to get on the ones and twos, or what inspired that first love?
Well, when you're young, you try to aspire to be like somebody else. And I think in my younger days, hip hop was really coming into its own. And you had DJs like Jam Master Jay, the Grandmaster Flash,
right, and all them guys.
Yeah. So, you try to emulate them, but you try.
It doesn't always work out the way that it does.
But right. Once you try to get where you get, get with them,
you
do what you do.
Man.
Yeah. Create your own lane.
Right, I feel you. So, from Petersburg to Richmond, 106.5 The Beat, what's the Street Sweepers brand?
Well, actually, Street Sweepers brand, that came from Kay Slade. Shout out to Kay Slade.
Okay, shout out Kay Slade.
And shout out to my man, the heavy hitter, Lonnie B, because I think they came at Lonnie first, and Lonnie was like, "No, I'm already, a heavy hitter, brand." And he was like, "But I think I got somebody for y'all that'll fit the criteria." So, shout outs to Lonnie because Lonnie made that happen for me. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay.
So, it's my dog, too.
Okay. The Oop.
That's the best Oop. DJ around.
Oh, okay.
I said that. Hey. Lonnie B, number one.
No doubt. That was the Oop, like Chris Paul to Blake.
Already.
Chris
Paul to DeAndre right now.
DeAndre,
Blake on the shelf right now.
Yeah. You're right, man. I don't know what's going on, man.
I do.
You got a little inside knowledge?
No, I'm just joking. I'm a Clippers fan on the low, though.
Oh, okay. I could do that.
Yeah.
So, being one of the OGs, one of the pioneers, obviously,
appreciate
like you
that.
Said, DJ, Line B won.
It's a lot of hellfire DJs in this city. You got DJ Mark, you got DJ Drake, you got RJ, Skip. You got DJs that are talented out here, man. They hold their own, So
facts.
Shout outs to them.
No doubt. Where do you see it when you look at, you got artists that come through here all the time, that come through and sit down here. When you look at the industry and then you look at the market here, the local market here, what do you see, some of the differences? Or why haven't Richmond been able to have that breakthrough?
Well, actually, Richmond hasn't had the breakthrough because I guess I can be perfectly honest to say it's too many crabs in the barrel, man. And everybody once everybody get halfway out that barrel, they're pulling each other back in. Right. You know what I'm saying? Right. I mean, you know, it's a lot of talent here, just like it's a lot of talent in Petersburg, where right. I'm from. And, you know, it's like trying to help somebody out, you know, it's like it's always a competition here. It's no continuity here, man. I mean, nobody is trying to look out for each other. You got some DJs that are like that, but so, hey, it is what it is.
So, I mean, it's not one person. I don't believe, you know, this is hard as far, you know, this is hard to believe that not one person was able to figure it out. Even if they wasn't able to say, okay, I can't go to the radio station, or, you know what I'm saying? Like, how they figure they should be able to get on or whatever. Or they just decided, well, let me try the independent grind or something like that. And it still doesn't seem like a breakthrough has happened.
Well, like, you had something that could have broke through. I mean, you know, like, I don't know if you remember, but the GMGB movement, the disco baller movement, that was huge.
Yeah,
they could have been gone. I mean, it was their choice. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? They made the choice.
That's true.
And, you know, they could have had a record deal, I'm sure. I mean, you know, because their brand had took off, you know what I mean? And that would have opened doors for a whole lot of other people. So.
Right. That's true.
You know, shout out to Skills, because Skills did it.
Yeah, that's true.
Skills
that's
definitely
true. Yeah, you know yeah, shout out to Skills. Well, you know, yeah, that is a fact.
Yeah.
That's a fact. So let me ask you this. Do you think, because from what I see, you know, you got a lot of different rappers, you know, on both sides of the water and stuff. But it just seems like that's what it is. It's just a lot of rappers.
Yeah.
You know, everybody rapping. You know, where's the? It's a lot more to getting a deal or having a deal than just rapping.
Yeah.
And then just the music part of it. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of business that go into it.
Exactly.
Branding.
Exactly.
And, you know, stuff like that. So what do you say when you see artists, you know, they might be handing out CDs or whatever, and what do you see for artists that's saying, oh, well, radio don't fuck with me, or, you know, them DJ niggas don't fuck with us?
Yeah, well, number one, you got to figure out who you are first. Identity is number one. I mean, you got to determine who you're going to be. If you're going to rap like this person today, you got to be continuous with it. I mean, you got to find your own lane, number one.
Right.
Number two, I mean, get your paperwork straight. You know what I'm saying? If you want to do that, I mean, you don't want us to keep playing music for your homeboys to hear or
right.
for somebody to hear just because you want to get a thrill out of hearing yourself on the radio, you know?
Mm.
Get that paperwork done, man. And then once you pick up that following, then somebody in another market can say, okay, well, he got his city on Smash, so, I mean, we're going to rock
right.
with him, you know?
Right, right. It's, you got to get a you know, business
mind. Yeah, you got to get that business mind.
Together, you got to get all that in line.
You can't come to somebody half as hot and then talking like, you know, hey, man, yo, man, I got the hottest joint in the city. Let the city be the judge of that.
Right.
Let the city judge that.
Remember that everybody, to them, got the hottest joint
in
the city.
Yeah, everybody. That's what you don't know how many times. If I had a dime for every time somebody told me that,
right, I got the
working wouldn't even be a problem no more.
Right, he could be rich.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Because, and that's what it is. Like you have to get that business right.
Right.
What's the deal with the R&B? How you feel as far as the local scene with the R&B?
Well, it's not a whole lot of local R&B around here. Let's be clear on that. I mean, but
there
is a lane right there for somebody to pick up the ball and run with it because. Right.
I'm a huge R&B fan too.
Yeah, so am I. You had Trey. Trey did it. Chris did it. You had a couple of R&B cats around here. Governor could have did it. I mean, it was just a whole lot of people that I mean that had the formula.
Yeah, that's true.
And then fell by the wayside. But shout outs to Chris and Trey because they still holding their own. You know. And
I'm a huge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I mean, you know, it's not a whole lot of R&B around here. And it's not a whole lot of female
R&B
people that you can holler at either.
Right.
I mean, you know, because at the end of the day, if you're a rapper and you got just a random chick off the street singing on your hook.
Mm. He's like, right, exactly. Exactly.
Okay, you know where I'm going with
it. Exactly, yo. Right. It's just like you gotta be able to see what you're trying to do.
Exactly.
You have to have that vision. You already have that. I already have that ambition. Mm-hmm. So, what you got in the pipeline? You know what I'm saying? What you got coming?
Well, I'm about to do a showcase.
Okay.
I mean, you know, but I'm gonna filter out all this bullshit.
Oh, the bullshit.
Exactly. I got to filter it out.
Okay.
Man.
I'm about to.
I mean, because if not, the showcase will start at 7 o'clock and it won't be over till 2 o'clock in the morning. So
right,
I'm going to filter out all the bullshit, you know, and you know, and be like, hey, this is what I'm doing.
You actually might have a registration form.
Yeah, you but, know, you know, they got to, they going to get, some of them going to get in their feelings, but they'll be all right. You know what I'm saying? I mean, if they get in their feelings, then let's take it as a sign. I mean, go back to the drawing board.
One thing about it is business is business. You
exactly.
know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So, you know, as long as you're doing business, you can't even, you can get in your feelings. You can't be mad.
Yeah, but you can be, you can be my boy. I mean, and if your music's some trash, man, hey, bro, I can't do nothing with that.
Right, exactly. You know what I'm saying? Go back. You got to come stronger.
I mean, I think I've been out here long enough to say that I can pretty much critique who's hot and who's not, you know what
right.
I'm saying? So, I mean, you know.
Okay.
At the end of the day, and it ain't no showing favorites. You
yes,
got to go with what's hot.
Yeah, right, yeah.
I don't know damn where you from.
So let me ask you this. So when you get a record, you know, somebody, you listen to a record, you pick up a record, when you get it, what do you listen for? What, you know, what is Foot listening for when you like?
Well, if the first 30 seconds don't get me,
You're done.
I'll give it another minute. Mm.
But it's like
after that,
turkey on Thanksgiving,
man,
done.
Yeah,
it's over.
Yes, yes.
It cooked them.
Either you gonna make it to the stack or you gonna make it to the trash.
Dang. Well, yeah.
That's,
I mean, that's pretty much it. I mean, because you see, and from what I heard, you know, a lot of people say, well, yeah, Richmond sound like this or Richmond sound like that.
Exactly. That's what I was saying earlier. You gotta find your own identity. Find your own lane. Stop trying to be like everybody else. Stop
right.
If you heard Amigos rapping, don't come out here with a record that sounds just like the
Amigos.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I mean, if you heard Future rapping, everybody won't go back to auto-tune. Man. Come on, man.
They won't lay up off the auto-tune.
Exactly.
And then they hire a dude, a person that's like sleep on it. They just sleep on the auto-tune and they just rap.
And then, you know, you got people that get their, they get a record and they get that little sample that Future got. You heard that
right.
in everybody's song.
Right.
Come
right.
on, man.
Right, right. Now
I mean, then you might think it's the same producer's track, you know?
Yeah, man. You like is you have to have that distinguishing sound.
Exactly.
You have to distinguish yourself and,
exactly.
and take yourself out the crowd.
There you go.
You know, so for I mean, social media, how can they keep up with you?
I'm on social media at Cool DJ Foot. I'm on Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter. All of that. I mean, you want to get at me? Let's get at me. I mean, and I'll follow back. Well, you know what? I don't have any more space on my other Facebook page, but Cool DJ Foot, I mean, you can get on it. Better get on there now while you can, though. I mean, because after a while, it's going to be a wrap.
Hey, it's going to be registration forms for that, too. Registration forms for that, too. You have to fill this out
before you follow
Foot. You know what I'm saying? But, man, it was definitely checking in. Appreciate you coming to Campaign TV, you know, checking in with us.
Hey, man, I got to shout y'all cats out, man. Anytime you see some strong black brothers doing some positive stuff, man, hey, man, I'm all with it. Anytime y'all need me for anything, just holler, man. I mean,
no doubt.
And I know a whole lot of people say that. A whole lot of people say that. But I actually mean it.
No doubt.
And that's
no doubt.
Real.
No doubt, that's love.
So
right
Campaign
there.
TV, y'all better rock with it, man, because you need to get with it, or just like some of these rappers, you can get with it.